Hey, it's time for That's Life with Julie, and today I'm going to pick up on a story that I alluded to the night of the wedding, like at midnight when I mentioned this. See, in January of this year, I had a dream. I actually had a nightmare because I dreamed that I was in charge of the wedding, like all of it, and the reception, and the dinner. And in my dream, the potatoes were not cooking. The baked potatoes weren't cooking. And so I was like running around all over the place at the big red barn, and I'm trying to figure out how to get them cooked. And in the background, I can hear my daughter's voice, and she's saying, "Mom, where's Mom? Mom, we need you for pictures. Where's my mom?" And in my dream, they took the family pictures without me. I guess they just photoshopped my head in there or something. What is with that? It was a nightmare, I tell you. And I woke up and I was practically hyperventilating. And I was like, there's just no way. There's no way I can do this wedding by myself. I'm a horrible party person. I had like one party for Kristen at her birthdays and that was it. And the rest were, I didn't even try. I'm awful at this. So I called my friend Laura Anderson and I took her up on her offer to help out. I was like, Laura, will you please be in charge of everything? I'll write the checks and you take care of everything. So for the next 9 and a half, 10 months, we worked with Kristen and we made all these plans. And so the wedding day came, October 22nd. It was gorgeous. It was beautiful. The weather was warm and sunshiny, and the wedding dress bustle got, you know, properly done and oh, it was just wonderful. I mean, it was just beautiful. And I enjoyed the day from the beginning to the end. I met with Laura like at 9 o'clock that morning out at the barn. And then we took care of all the details. And then I got dressed and I took care of Kristen. And I never thought about anything to do with the wedding other than being present right there. So the evening wears on. It's probably about 9:30, 10 o'clock and the music's playing and I'm talking with everyone and just enjoying it. And Laura comes up to me and she says, "So, maybe now would be a good time to tell you about our little incident with the potatoes." I was like, "Get out. What are you talking about, the potatoes?" And she said, "Yeah." She said, "Turns out we had too many roasters plugged in because all my Facebook friends offered their roasters. You're so amazing. And we were overloading the circuit. So we had the potatoes in roasters cooking. We thought they were cooking. And then Todd, her husband, goes to check and the lights are off. And it turns out they overblew the circuits and the roasters weren't on. The potatoes weren't cooking." How crazy is that? Am I like a prophetess? Maybe I'm a prophetess, I don't know. But I had a dream in January that those potatoes weren't cooking. And here's what I thought. I was like, oh my word, if I had been in charge and that had happened, I would have missed everything. I probably would have missed the pictures, but I certainly would not have been present in Kristen's day and for Andy's day like I was. So this is a public shout out in two areas. One, to you, Laura Anderson, for doing such an amazing job at organizing and just, I mean, it's just amazing what you did. And then for everyone who followed along, Trisha and Sin and Sherry and Todd and Scott and Susie and everyone who made Kristen's day and made my day so wonderful and Rick's day. It was amazing. So shout out to you. And then shout out to God. Woohoo! For giving me that dream in January. You know, scripture says God speaks once, yea, twice in dreams. So here's what I think. You need to pay attention to those dreams. Now, some of them, granted, forget about them. They're just flat out weird. But there are some of those that maybe deep is calling to deep and trying to give us a heads up about electrical currents that aren't going to hold all the roasters. You never know. So that's Life with Julie. And I will be speaking to you later, perhaps in